everybody. Scott Spreitzer here, DocSports.com, and welcome to the update for Monday, May 13th, 2019. I got a free pick coming up in just a moment, along with our NFL thumbnail sketches. We're going to wrap up the AFC North on today's report with the Baltimore Ravens over-under wins total. We'll get to that in just a bit. First, quick note, if you have yet to become a member over at DocSports.com, it's a real cool way to give it a trial run. You click on the link below this video, get yourself set up for a free $60 account on Monday. You can use those free $60 on any of my daily packages or any other capper at DocSports.com for that matter. Free $60 account, great way to give it a trial run. Start it out by clicking on the link below the video. I think you'll be glad that you did. All right, let's recap Sunday before we jump into Monday's card. I lost yesterday's 7-star play with the Toronto Raptors. Well, there's a little smidgen of time where it looked like Toronto might be able to pull away and get us a cover, but you know, 99% of the time, it looked like the Sixers were the right side as far as the spread was concerned, and we unfortunately had Toronto as a 7-star. As far as Kawhi Leonard, man, the guy is just unbelievable. To me, my opinion, for my money, the best NBA player right now. And we saw what he did yesterday. He locks down on opposing offensive studs. And then at the other end, he can score 40, 42 points. He hits the game winner at the end. I mean, it defies all mathematics and logic by bouncing off the rim four or five times. Had an 18-foot arc by the time it was in midair before it got to the rim. And they win the game on that last second shot by Kawhi Leonard. Boy, he's going to be tough coming up against Milwaukee in the Eastern Conference Finals as a lockdown defender, also on the offensive end, also on the glass. The guy's just extremely amazing, as you already know. But again, we lost the 7-star, and that stunk, obviously. We don't have a play on Monday in basketball because they won't be racking it up again until Tuesday. No basketball, no NBA on Monday night. But we'll talk a little bit more about the Eastern and Western Conference Finals on Tuesday's video. Of course, the NBA gets back underway on Tuesday night. As far as baseball, we lost a 3-unit on Saturday, but our 4-unit plays swept the weekend, including last night with the Chicago Cubs over the Milwaukee Brewers. So we're going to go into Monday looking to make it 3-0 since Saturday with our 4-unit baseball plays. We have a Monday mismatch. Cool thing is, as far as that line is concerned, the price, it's where we want it. We don't have to lay a runs line here. It's not some crazy line on a game that we call a mismatch. Yeah, there's value on our side, and we like it here on Monday. That'll be available on Monday morning. DocSports.com will look to make it 3-0 since Saturday with those 4-unit baseball plays. Back in action in the NHL, I passed yesterday game 2 between the Hurricanes and the Bruins. Boston up 2-0 now. We had game 1 of the Western Conference Finals. We had San Jose, nice winner there, and we're involved in game 2. Game 2 up in San Jose between the Blues and the Sharks, and we have the side rated 4 units. We'll be aiming for our 5th straight NHL playoff winner on Monday night. So go grab that also Monday morning at DocSports.com. Major League Baseball, NHL, return to NBA on Tuesday. That's what's going on for us. All right, we'll get to the goods. We'll get to that free pick in just a moment for Monday, but I want to close out my AFC North thumbnail sketches with the Baltimore Ravens, the final team that we need to talk about here from this division. Over-under as we speak in most shops is 8.5 with the under minus $1.30, the over right around plus $1.10. I'm going to tell you right off the top that I like the under here, minus $1.30, under 8.5 wins for the Baltimore Ravens. As far as Lamar Jackson, listen, maybe John Harbaugh and his staff can slowly turn this kid around as far as his accuracy and his decision-making is concerned. I know he was thrown into the mix last year, so he relied a lot more on first instinct, which is to run the football for Lamar Jackson. A problem is, as you all know, as everybody knows, over the course of the long haul, you don't stay in the NFL real long if you're a run-first quarterback. You don't get to the promised land in the NFL if you're a run-first quarterback. Last year, you look at his accuracy, it wasn't good. He was one of the worst passers in the NFL when it came to completion percentage. And when it came to his off-target percentage, there was only one quarterback worse than him on the entire season. I'm not the first one to mention this, but I want to tell you about it in case you have overlooked it. Lamar Jackson, a quarterback last year for Baltimore, when he started, they averaged just under 2 touchdowns per game on offense. We know what they were last year. They were all about defense. They did a great job of slowing teams down. Problem is, they lose a bunch. They lose a ton of talent on the defensive side of the football from last year. But here's the good news. The good news is, I thought their draft was as good as anybody in the NFL. In fact, if you sat down and wanted to debate about it, I think Baltimore Baltimore might have had the best draft top to bottom in the entire NFL last week. I love that they went out and got receivers for Lamar Jackson to work with. I think that was smart. I know their top receiver they brought in is a little bit short, but he's got good talent, and I think he's going to be a big deal for this team and make some noise. If not this year, then maybe late in the year or next season. But again, they went out and they got receivers. They got Justice Hill, the running back out of Oklahoma State. I think he's going to be a great complement this year, and I think next year he probably takes over as the number one. I really do. As far as the defense is concerned, they did address some areas where they lost some talent, but again, I don't see any like immediate impact players on defense to start 2019. I think it's going to take some time to develop these guys on defense. So you look at it, you got a quarterback who needs, still obviously needs time to reach the type, to become the type of quarterback that John Harbaugh wants as far as in the passing game is concerned. You've got a defense where they had to go out and replace some serious talent. That's going to take some time to get these guys to become impact players on that defensive unit. So listen, the future is bright down the road for Baltimore, not so much this season. And again, if you look at their schedule, their first seven games, I think they've got a great shot at 3-4 straight up. That's not horrible. They'll go into their bye thinking that they've got a shot to reach the postseason if they start 3-4. The problem is, it's over the last nine games where I think this team is going to struggle, and I really don't believe they're going to win more than seven games on the season. So my play on the Baltimore Ravens for all of those reasons that I just mentioned is to play under 8.5 wins minus $1.30 with the Baltimore Ravens. I think they get to about seven wins. That's going to wrap up our AFC North preview. We'll jump into the AFC South when we start talking a little bit more NFL either on Tuesday or Wednesday's video. Again, before I get to the free pick, I wanted to mention what's going on today. Monday, DocSports.com for me. We're aiming for our third straight four-unit play since Saturday. One play, it's a small schedule. One play in Major League Baseball at DocSports.com for me on Monday. Well, it's a four-unit play. We'll look to go to 3-0. We're looking to make it five straight NHL playoff wins on Monday as I've got a four-unit play game two between the Blues and the Sharks. NBA, of course, returning on Tuesday, as we mentioned. All right, let's get to our free pick for Monday's card. If I don't pull the microphone off of me here. And we are going to play the under between the Astros and the Tigers on Monday night. And you've got a nice pitching matchup here. In fact, if you look at Boyd for Detroit and what he's done so far this season, I mean, Detroit's only 18-20, yet they're 5-2 in his last seven starts. He's pitching extremely well, especially at home. Actually, it doesn't matter whether he's home or away. He's pitched well on both road mounds and home mounds, but he's even better at Comerica so far this season. I think he's going to be able to slow down Houston, hold them in check in this particular game. But as far as the other side is concerned, we're talking about Peacock in this one for the Houston Astros. He's going to go up against a Detroit offense that has really been missing in action for this season. They've scored a grand total of 13 runs in their last five games. And if you look at the course of the season, they're 24th in OBP, they're 25th in team batting average, and that all comes together and finds that they're scoring just 3.49 runs per game on the season. I think you're going to see a low-scoring game. I like this game to stay under the total of 8. The Astros, the Tigers, under 8 on Monday is your free pick. All right, listen, that's going to do it for us on Monday. Don't forget about that free $60 account. Click on the link to get started with that. If you like these reports, then be sure to click on that thumbs up button. Be sure to subscribe. We do appreciate those who have done so thus far. Let's put Monday in the win column. I'm Scott Spreitzer, DocSports.com. Right back here Tuesday morning, 5 a.m. Eastern, 2 a.m. Pacific.